Good morning, good morning, good morning. Hello, folks. Happy Wednesday morning. Coming to you a little bit later than we have been, because I think we could get more on. Hello, Cassie. Bless you for coming on this morning. I'm just going to wait a few minutes before, so we can get an audience here and see what God does this morning. Hallelujah. God is amazing. Good morning, Shannon. I'm glad you got my notification that coming to you at 7. I think it's going to be better for people. We shall see. Doesn't matter. We're here to worship regardless. Amen. Glory to God. Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you. We ask if you could like and share. Good morning, Susanna. Good morning, Carrie. Good morning, good morning. It's a blessing to have you guys all on this morning. I know that God is going to meet you where you're at this morning. And there's just something about coming into his presence that is first thing in the morning and giving him the first of our day. Hallelujah. That's right, you are at work, Shannon. I forget that. Hallelujah. Bless you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Bless her, Lord God. Amen. How's everybody doing this morning? Good morning, Kathy. Or it's not good morning to you. It's good afternoon, I believe. Or good evening, even. Hallelujah. If you could like and share this broadcast, I appreciate it. And we'll get going here shortly. I just want to wait a few more minutes to see people come on this morning. Hallelujah. God is good. I know that I've noticed a difference the last few mornings. Getting up and on purpose. You know, sometimes we've got a purpose in our heart to do something. And just to be on purpose, good morning, Suzanne. Say, I'm going to give you the first of my day. I'm going to give you the best of my day, and he takes care of the rest of the day. Amen. So sometimes it's a sacrifice. Sometimes getting up in the morning is not the easiest thing to do, but we can purpose in our hearts, God, you are worthy, no matter what time of day it is. But I love to bless him first thing in the morning and to give him the glory that's due his name. Hallelujah. If you could like and share this broadcast, I appreciate it. And we're going to get going here this morning. Hallelujah. Good morning, Adam. Thank you for joining me this morning. We are going to worship our Lord and Savior this morning. He is so good. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. He says, this is the day that the Lord has made. Yesterday was the day that the Lord has made, but today, his mercies are new. Every morning, every single morning, his mercies are new. And today is no different. He says, you can't live on yesterday's manna. You can't live on yesterday's mercies, but today, you're going to receive brand new, created mercies. That's what that means. It means today he's actually created new mercies for you today. So all you have to do is grab them, hold on to them, and say, Father, I thank you for your mercies today, Father, for what you have in store for me this day. I thank you in Jesus' name that the mercies are there and the grace is there to get through it. Amen. Hallelujah. He says, if you seek me first, all these other things, they just are added. They're just added to. Hallelujah. Glory to God. So, just before we start worship this morning, I have a scripture in Psalms 29. I was reading this morning, and this one small scripture just popped out at me, and I thought, wow, this is a good one to start my day. Psalm 29, and it's verse 11, and I'm reading it right out of the Message Bible this morning, and he says this: God makes his people strong. and God gives his people peace. Simple. God makes his people strong, and God gives his people peace. So today, for those that feel weak, those that don't have any strength, those that feel like, hey, God, I just need to get through this day, he says, I'm going to come and he says, I give my people strength. I make my people strong. So today, just grab a hold of his strength. Say, hey, Father, I may be weak, but you are strong, and I thank you for strengthening me today. I thank you for giving me the peace of God today. No matter what I face today, in my day, in my night, my sleep, whatever it is today, in your work, in your family, he's going to make you strong, and he's going to give you peace throughout this day, because our God is the most amazing God. Amen. Hallelujah. We give you praise this morning, God. We set our sights on you, Father. We set our sights on you to worship you, to praise you, to adore you. We give you this day. We thank you for strength for the day. Strength for the day. Sweet mercies for the day. Sweet mercies for the day. Father, we thank you that, God, that when we are weak, that you are strong, Father, and that when we're anxious or fearful, Father, your word says that you give us peace. So peace be to you today in Jesus' name.
Turn.
broadcast. We just come together for a time of worship and prayer and praise to start our day. Hallelujah.
We make a miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God. That is who you are. Come on, it's who he is.
He's worthy. He's worthy. He's worthy. Open your mouth and taste. Open your eyes and see how good God is. Taste and see that the Lord is good this morning. Blessed are those are you who run to him. Come on, we need to stop running from him and start running to him. Come on, he said, blessed are you who run to him. No shame in running to God this morning. He says, worship God if you want the best. Worship, listen to this. This is good. Worship opens doors to all his goodness. Anybody that needs their doors open this morning, worship is the key. It says worship opens doors to all his goodness. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. We thank you, Father, that you give us keys to open doors, God. One of those keys is worship, Father. Father, I passionately praise you. We worship you this morning with all our heart. All our souls, all our minds, all our strength. We taste and see that you are good, Lord. We taste and see that you are good, Lord. We taste and see that you are good, Lord. Yes, you are good, Lord. Sing this with me. God, you're so good. Come on, tell them today.
So good, yeah, God, you're so good. I just want to tell you today, God,
on, this is a declaration this morning that you are blessed, you are called, you are healed, you are whole, you are saved in Jesus' name, you're highly favored, you're anointed, you're filled with his power for the glory of Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Open the doors.
of glory, we invite you into our place, into our space. This morning, fill every house, fill every car, fill every place that we are, God, with your glory this morning.
Oh,
presence he's given us. Come on, courage. He's given us faith. He's given us everything we need to get through this day, to get through this day victoriously, to get through this day with everything that we need. Read you this psalm in Psalm 138. Thank you. Everything in me says thank you. There's something about coming to the Lord and saying, thank you, God. We just thank you. There's so much to thank Him for. Thank you. Everything in me says thank you. Angels listen as I sing my thanks. Come on, we have an audience of angels that are with us this morning, worshiping with us. I kneel and worship, facing your holy temple. And I say it again, thank you. I think in Psalms 100 it says in the Message versions that come into His presence with thanksgiving is the password. It's our password. You know, we have passwords for everything. But thank you, just coming to Him with simple thanks is a password into His presence, amen? Thank you for your love. This is what we can thank Him for this morning. We thank Him for His love. We thank you for your faithfulness. Most holy is your name. Most holy is your word. The moment I called out, you stepped in. Come on, the moment we call out, He is right there. He's stepping in. And made my life large with strength. Come on, I really feel that today, that there's a strength coming upon His people. As you're listening this morning, He's strengthening you. Hallelujah. The moment that I call out, the moment that we call out, He says, hey, I got you back. I'm here with strength for you this morning. And when they hear what you have done, all the earth's kings will say thank you. There's something that is contagious about saying thank you. There's a reason why we teach our children to say thank you, please, all these other things. They'll sing of what you've done, how great the glory of God. And here's why. God high above sees far below. No matter the distance, He knows everything about us. So if the same God that knows everything about you, He created you, is the same God that can certainly hear you, listen to you, and maintain you day after day. Hallelujah. He knows us. And when I walk into the thick of trouble, keep me alive in the angry turmoil. With one hand, strike my foes. With the other hand, save me. Now, this is it. This is it. This is a word today. Finish what you started in me, God. Your love is eternal. Don't quit on me now. So, Father, we cry out to you. Say, finish what you started in us. Come on, he's done a great work in so many of us. He's done a great work in so many of us, each and every one of us. But our cry today is, God, finish what you've started in us. We give you permission to continue your work in us. Come on, he's not going to stop. He's not going to quit on you. He's not going to quit on you. His love is eternal. He is not going to quit on you. Sometimes we feel like we quit on him. But you know what? He says, there's no way you could ever exhaust my love. You can never exhaust my presence. You can never, never exhaust my mercy and my grace. So today he's reaching out to you. He says, come on, just say thank you for his grace and his mercy and his love, for his faithfulness. He's finishing the good work that he started in you. Hallelujah. Amen. Finish what you started, God. Finish what you start. That's our cry of our heart today, to finish what you started, God. You are the I am. You are the I am. You are everything we need, God. Hallelujah. To finish what you started in us. We're not going to worry about what you've started in somebody else, God. We're just going to worry about us. We're even not going to worry. We're just going to be concerned about what you're doing in us, God. Finish what you started in Jesus' name. Creator God and Lord, with worship in our hearts, we come before your throne. Together we proclaim, throughout all thank you. have gone too far. And says, I don't know, I hear you, but I just think that I've gone too far for the mercy and the love of God. And he just wants to say this morning that he hears your heart and that he has you right in the palm of his hand. He has not gone anywhere. And all you have to do is say, God, forgive me, and he's right there, and he comes right back into your life. The greatest thing is that it's like riding a bike. You just get right back on where you left off and say, hey, God is good, his mercy and his truth. Come on, they're covering you today. His forgiveness, his blood. We've never gone too far. We've never, ever, ever gone too far. So, Father, I thank you for those people or that person, Lord. I pray for them right now. In Jesus' name, that he or she come back to you, Father. That they just run after you, Father. They run after you. They don't run from you, but they're running to you today. Saying, God, this is a new day. This is a fresh day. Come on, he's given you courage to walk through this day. He's given you a strength like you've never seen before. Don't be afraid to fail. Just be, know that he's got you in the palm of his hands, in Jesus' name. Day. It's a new beginning. You're going to remember this day that you got on this morning. And God met you right where you are. Father, we thank you. Father, that you're going to finish what you started in us. You finished what you started in us, Father. His word says you finish what you started in us, God. Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Thank you all for coming on this morning. We thank you so much. Father, I thank you. We just want to bless you this morning. Come on, just bless him. Just bless him and thank him for meeting you right where you are this morning. His presence to come into your day, to walk with you, to talk with you. Come on, let's just sing this song to Jesus this morning before we finish up. It's an oldie. It's a good prayer. Oh, bless you. We worship you. We thank you in Jesus' mighty name. Ooh, amen. Well, God bless you. I want to thank you again for coming online this morning. And it seems like maybe this hour worked a little better. So tomorrow morning and Friday morning, we will be same place, same channel, same time, 7 a.m. Eastern time. And be great to come on and worship with you one more time. And bless the Lord together. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm believing that today is going to be a miracle day for you, that He's going to work it throughout your day like you've never seen Him work before. And Rebecca, I'm looking forward to a testimony of some open doors that are going to open for you. In Jesus' name, you're welcome, Peggy. It's a blessing. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. We thank you, Father. Yes, Lord. Sometimes it's so hard to just stop. You just want to keep going, in Jesus' name. Father, I pray for the health of everyone listening, Father, that you heal them, heal their bodies, Father. Emotional healing, Father, whatever they need today, God, that you meet them right where they're at. Father, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. So rise up today, and be the victorious children of God that you are. Amen. God bless you. We love you too. And remember, in just about an hour, Eddie will be on for his morning session. So you get worship, you get word. God is good. Amen. God bless you guys. Thank you for watching. I love you. If you want to sow a seed this morning, we appreciate it. Just go to heartsablazeministries.net and to the donate page, and you'll see the options there. So love you, appreciate you, and God bless you. And until tomorrow morning, we shall see you then. Love you guys. Bye.